Hi, thank you for watching a new video blog. Overpopulation is really one of the biggest myths that people believe in nowadays. If you watch scientific programs, if you read scientific magazines, if you listen to the news, mainstream news, you might think that the world is exploding with people, that there's an overpopulation problem, and yeah, we really have to reduce the world population. Of course, this is just a myth. And quite the opposite is happening. We're not having an overpopulation problem, we have an underpopulation problem. The problem is the population is shrinking. Now, of course, people that watch mainstream media say, oh, you're crazy, or you're crazy, you don't follow the scientists. You know, the scientists know all. They tell you that we have overpopulation problem. It's exploding, the world is exploding. Look at Africa. Well, look at Africa. Also in Africa, the birth rates are dropping rapidly. And it's all because of the urbanization that is going on worldwide. And then they say, well, look at Asia. I say, Asia, well, what's going on in Asia? Also there, highly urbanization, people moving from the rural parts to the cities to find work. It's happening also in the poorer parts of Asia, where they supposedly have this overpopulation problem. The birth rates are dropping drastically. And of course, Japan is one of the worst. Probably their population is cut by half in maybe 20 years. The same is happening in Europe. None of the countries in Europe, except for Turkey only, is having a replacement population, is having a replacement growth birth rate. The birth rates are not even good enough to replace the current population. And the population is growing, yes. In Holland we grew from 15 million when I was a kid to 17, maybe 18 million by 2022. But it's all because of immigration. If you put 2 million immigrants, which they still have a higher birth rate than the European, than the original inhabitants of Europe, yeah, sure, you keep the population, or you grow it by a little, but by no means is the world population growing. And quite the opposite is true. All the countries in the world are having slower growth and rapidly slower growth, even in the countries where the people say, oh yeah, all these Muslim countries, they have like 12 children per family, even they are now dropping rapidly to maybe 3 or 2 children and maybe less. And then you say, like, look around you, the city where I live in, it's there's so many inhabitants, it's growing, it's growing, it's growing, the cities are growing so strongly, you see that the world population is growing. Yeah, the city is growing because people are forced to move to the cities to find work, and they force off their lands, they are not able to live off the lands anymore. It's still continuing, the small villages in the rural areas, also in Europe, they're getting emptier and emptier, and finally they're dying. There's no small cities anymore in rural areas, no small villages. Yeah, the city is exploding, but it just means that a little part of the country is attracting all the people and the rest of the country is dying. And even in the city, if you look around, it's all like single households. People that are living alone, or people that are living together, don't have any children. Or maybe they have 1 or 2. It's below replacement level. Replacement is at least 2.2. So you should have 3 children to have a normal replacement rate. And that's what is happening. The city, yeah, the city is exploding. It's getting more expensive to live in the city, but the rest of the country is dying because all the people are moving to the cities. And even then, the country is dying, because without immigration, Holland will be less inhabitants. So, yes, to think that overpopulation is a problem is really, you don't get it. You are, sorry, but you are misled by the mainstream media, by the science. They want you to believe that there's an overpopulation problem, of course, because it plays in their favor. They want you to believe that you are a horrible person, that you are polluting the planet, that you are really bad if you want any children. They want to control you. They want a smaller world population. Of course, they will tell you that that's a problem. There's a overpopulation on the planet. But we're now at a great turnaround where the population of the planet will shrink. And it will continue to shrink because people are not believing anymore, because of the brainwashing from the media and the science, that having a big family is natural, it's something good. No, they're shamed into having a small family or no children. They're shamed in believing that being a parent is a waste of time, that you should focus on a career. By doing so, we are not ever stopping the decreasing world population. It will continue, unless people go back, of course, to nature, natural life. We are continuing to see a shrinking world population until there's maybe 1 billion, and then there's maybe 500 million people, and then 200 million people, and then finally the elites have what they want. They can control people perfectly, and that's what they want. They don't want a growing world population because it means that they have a harder time controlling all these people. They finally want to make humans extinct, and that so that there's only robots, machines running the planet for the small elites that is on top, that we don't know where they are, we cannot see them. So that's why they make you believe that the world is overpopulated, that you are should be ashamed, that you want children, that you want a big family. It's all very clear if you understand it, if you see that it's not, there is no overpopulation, there's even a problem with underpopulation of the planets. Like I say, all around the world the numbers are dropping heavily, quickly, and that means that that it will continue, because if you go from a family of 12 children to the next generation of 3, and then to 1, and then to maybe 1 or 0, that is a problem, because it means that you get cut in half every generation. And it's very unnatural. If you put away politics, if you look at nature, it's very unnatural. If you look at yourself, what do I want in life? Having a big family, at least 3, 4, 5 children, it's very natural. It's a human desire. It's a great desire. We need it. And I can go along with the idea that we are destroying the planet. Yes, we are destroying the planet. But if you have a family of 12 children and you raise them off-grid, close to nature, with your own piece of land where you have permaculture and where you have your own animals, have your own chicken, have rabbits, have a cow, have horses, etc., it means you are in a sustaining environment. And if you connect with a tribe, with people that are extended family, then you are even be able to lower the stress on nature and be even a part of nature, like a natural way of living. So that is of course what you want. That is of course why you should have a desire to have many children. If you look at tribes, natural tribes, primitive tribes, they all have 4, 5, 6 children. It's very natural because something can happen to you, to one of the children, and there's enough children to help the tribe survive. It's natural, it's very good. If you want this, you're healthy. Very good. So, no, there is no of a population. There is, that's just truly a myth. And if you say now, yeah, I have to study, you know, fine, do whatever you want to do, I don't care. I don't believe in science. Science is just stories, philosophical stories that are being taught, and science is just make the numbers, you know. They create some numbers to have the philosophical idea of not having children, to live an unnatural life, forced upon you. They need something, they need proof, of course, to make you believe all this. So, no, there's no overpopulation, quite the opposite is happening. And if you want to live natural, you should have a big family and be proud of it, and don't even care about what people want to shame you into, like, oh, polluting, and oh, stress on blah blah CO2 emission, etc. Don't care about it. Live natural, have this big family, and teach your children to go back to nature, to go back to nature with them and live natural. So it was for today. Thank you for watching. See you next time.